गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर नितिन पडवन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ वेबिनार ऑन फेमस फेस्टिवल्स ऑफ इंडिया. एज वी ऑल नो दैट इंडिया इंडियन ओरिजिन, द ग्रेटनेस ऑफ अ कल्चर कैन बी फाउंड इन इट्स फेस्टिवल. The famous writer Siddharth Katrangada says, "The greatness of a culture can be found in its festivals." So, the greatness of a country like India can be examined by sparing at a glance a vivid and vivacious list of festivals in India. Such diverse cultures, culminating such varied festivals, and that too under the name of a single country, such in the greatness of Indian culture. In India, there live people of many religions. Secularism ties these multi-religious people together in the threat of unity. However, the dominant community living here is the Hindu, but it provides a safe, secure, and prosperous land for every community. We celebrate in India Diwali, Holi, Navratra, Dasera, Raksha Bandhan, and Pongal, all Hindu festivals. Eid for Muslims, Christian for Christmas, it is celebrated by Christians, but everyone participates in them with a zeal and a zest together. Okay, Indian festivals celebrated by varied culture and through their special rituals added to the colors of the Indian heritage. Some festivals welcome the season of the year. Some welcome the harvest, the rains, or the full moon. There are three types of festivals: national festivals, religious festival, and harvest festivals. In national festivals, which include Independence Day, Republic Day, and Gandhi Jayanti, we all aware that Independence Day, Republic Day, and Gandhi Jayanti. Next one is religious festivals. We all know that India is a land of many religions. In religious festivals, Diwali is the most important festival of all. The grand festival of light, that is Diwali. Diwali is regarded as one of the most important festival of the Hindu calendar. The festival is mainly associated with the lights, as it is called the festival of light. The literal meaning of Deepavali is in Sanskrit is a row of lamps. History tells us that the festival is celebrated mainly for 4 days, commence on Ashvabhuja Bahula Chaturdashi and concludes on Kartik Shuddha Vijayadashmi. Each day has a significant end story behind its celebration. We all know very well about Diwali. It is celebrated by sweets. Next one is Holi, the vibrant festival of colors. It is also known as festivals of color. It is celebrated on the day after the full moon in each March. Festival to celebrate good harvest, also called the festivals of colors. Holi is celebrated in 2 days. First day, day one, bonfire is light up at the night, and in day two, people go around and throw colored powder and water at each other, end with a feast at a friend's house in the evening. Third festival is Dasera. The festival is celebrated for 9 days. Dasera is witnessed the triumph of God good over evil. People sow seeds on the first day, consecrate the planets, watch the sprouting, and worship goddess Durga during the festival. This festival marks the end of the 9 day long festival of Navratras. The day is commemorated as the day Lord Ram attained victory over Ravana, and therefore this festival symbolizes the victory of good over the evil. There are many different ways of celebration of Dasera in India. As a celebration, the symbolic statues of Ravana and his brothers Meghnad and Kumbhakarna are built and placed at a different avenues to be burnt by an arrow of fire. Next is Navratri. We all aware regarding Navratri, the 9 days of fasting, faith and devotions. Navratri is one of the most important festival of India. This festival is celebrated by all people throughout India in different ways. In Gujarat, it is 9 day celebration of rejuvenating Garba nights and highly energetic. Dandiya Ras dances, people are dressed in beautiful, colorful, traditional clothes and the environment is very youthful and invigorating. Fasting is famous tradition of Hindu religion and it is associated with the scientific fact. Whenever there is a change in season, one should fast to give rest to their digestive system and boost their immunity for the next season. Next one is Krishna Janmashtami. 8 days after the full moon of Shravan falls the festival of Janmashtami, the birthday of Lord Krishna. The first day is Krishnashtami or Gokulashtami. The second day is called Kalashtami or more properly known as Janmashtami. People observe fast without water on this day, which is broken at midnight. At the midnight, the Lord's birth or there is a grand worship of Lord Krishna. The Lord is bathed with milk while his name is chanted 108 times. Next famous festival is Ganesh Chaturthi, that is 11 days of pampering Lord Ganesha. The fourth day of the first fortnight, that is Shukla Chaturthi, in the month of Bhadrapad of the Hindu lunisolar calendar, which correspond to August or September of the Gregorian calendar. Pujas are performed in the morning and at the evening. The first day is the day of Visarjan, immersion of an idol in water body. Cultural activities of singing, dancing and theatre and free medical and blood donation camps are held. Next one is Guru Purab. It is a religious procession and peaceful hymns of Sikhs, celebrated by the Sikhs sometimes in November. As the birthday of the founder of Sikhism, the celebrations are especially colorful in Punjab and Haryana. Sikhs do not worship idols and their festivities revolve around the 10 Sikh gurus. These gurus were responsible for shaping the beliefs of the Sikhs and their birthdays, known as Guru Parabs, are occasions for celebrations and prayer among the Sikhs. Next is Raksha Bandhan, strengthening the bond of. It is Raksha, it means protection, Bandhan means lasting the bond. It celebrates the relationship between brother and sisters. The full moon of Shravana month of the Hindu lunisolar calendar, which correspond to August of the Gregorian calendar. One of the famous festival in the list of festivals of India, Rakhi is celebrated among Hindu, signifying the brother-sister bonding. During Rakhi, the sister performs aarti, player applies tilak and ties Rakhi, a sacred thread, on the brother's wrist, wishing his well-being. The brother in return vows to protect the sister. Another festival which has a strong similar to Rakhi is Bhai Dooj. Next festival is Eidul Fitr. On the first day of the month of Shawwal of the lunar Hijri calendar, which correspond to July of the Gregorian calendar, there are a number of Muslim festivals. The Muslim festivals do not correspond to any particular date or month of the Gregorian calendar, as they are based on the Hijra, which follows a pure lunar reckoning. Eid al-Fitr is the festival that marks the end of the Ramzan period and usually falls on a new moon night in the month of September or October. Ramzan is the 9th month in the Muslim calendar. According to legend, the Holy Quran was revealed in this month. Eid is one of the major festivals in India in Muslim community. Okay. Next one is Muharram. Muharram is observed by the Muslim community across the world in commemoration of the martyrdom of Prophet Muhammad's grandson, Imam Hussein, along with his family and followers, who were killed in the Battle of Karbala in AD 680. The Prophet's son-in-law Ali And Ali's elder son Hassan are also remembered during this period as having suffered and died for righteous causes. Muharram is the first month of the Islamic calendar, which marks the beginning of the new Islamic year. It is also one of the four months where infighting is strictly prohibited, as the word Muharram has been derived from haram. Next festival is Bihu. It is a traditional New Year celebration of Assamese. Popular among the festivals of India in the northeast, Bihu is the harvest festival of Assam. During the month long celebrations, young men and women wear their traditional clothes and perform the Bihu dance in the villages, field and country yards. During Bihu celebrations in India, a community feast is held with a lot of fanfare. Key attractions are the Bihu dance and the local cuisine, coconut laddu, til pitha, phila pitha and fish pitika. Next festival is Hemis, soothing chants and colorful costumes. 10th day called Tishu is the local language of the Tibetan lunar month, which correspond to June or July of the Gregorian calendar. Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir are the in which this Hemis festival is celebrated most widely. It's the celebration of the birth anniversary of the spiritual leader Padmasambhava, founder of the Tibet Tantric Buddhism. Hemis is the two-day religious festival from Ladakh, is one of the most important festival of India. It attracts a lot of local and foreign tourists each year. The festivities include the Cham dance done by the priests to the tune of the traditional music of cymbals, drums, trumpets played by the monks. It's the among the most unique type of festival where the dancing priests dress up in elaborate brocade outfits and masks. Next one is Onam, welcoming the mighty Mahabali. It is in the month of Chingam of the Malayalam calendar, which correspond to August or September of the Gregorian calendar. It celebrates the homecoming of the legendary king Mahabali, celebrated by a people of all communities in the state of Kerala. The festival of Onam portrays the rich cultural heritage of Kerala, its golden past, rich tradition and prosperous present. The festival is celebrated for a period of 10 days, starting from the first day Atham and continuing 10th biggest day called Thiru Onam. Next one is Pongal, rich rangolis and sweet savories. Celebrated in Tamil Nadu, sometimes in January or February, at the end of the harvesting season for 4 days. Ponga literally translated means overflowing, and the festival is named thus due to the tradition of cooking the new rice in pots until they boil and overflow the pot. This is symbolic of abundance and prosperity. During Pongal, people give their thanksgiving to nature. Pongal people give thanks to the cows and buffaloes, and on the last day people go for picnic. Next festival is Easter, celebrating the resurrection of Jesus. Easter, also called Pascha, that is Greek, Latin or Resurrection Sunday. It is the festival and holiday commemorating the resurrection of Jesus from the dead, described in the New Testament as having occurred on the third day after his burial, following his crucifixion by the Romans at Calvary, c. 30 AD. Next festival is Christmas, the birth of Jesus Christ. The festival of Christmas celebrated the birth of Jesus Christ and conveys his message of love, tolerance and brotherhood on the most famous and awaited festivals in India. And the word Christmas happens to be of sheer significance for elders and children alike. Everyone, regardless of their religion, wait for this day. Children specifically for the surprise gifts from Santa. All the churches are lit up and decorated to celebrate the birth of Lord Jesus. Next festival is Baisakhi. Baisakhi is one of the rich tradition and cultural prosperity festival. It is celebrated by the Sikh community of Punjab and those around the world. It is celebrated the welcoming of the harvest season for the Rabi crops. The Sikhs celebrated this festival with a lot of excitement and enthusiasm by performing local folk dances such as Gidda and Bhangra. The festival is of great religious significance in India as it marks the day when the 10th Guru of Sikh, that is Guru Gobind Singh, laid out the foundation stone for the Panth Khalsa, the order, back in 1699. Next famous festival is Makar Sankranti, that is Hindus' New Year. Makar Sankranti is the real New Year of North Indians and Sikhs, which is celebrated just one day after Lohri. On this day, worship to God is performed to seek His blessings for the New Year. It is in the way the end of winter and beginning of spring, which means agricultural cycle for the farmers. The dates are set according to solar cycles, unlike other Hindu festivals where dates are decided by lunar cycles. People celebrate this day by flying kites and having savory bajre ki khichdi and sweet tea laddu. Gujaratis celebrate this festival by the name of Uttarayan. Next famous festival is Mahavir Jayanti, birth of Lord Mahavir. Mahavir Janma Kalyanak is an important day for the people from Jain religion as it marks the birth of Lord Mahavir. If you have noticed, the statue of Lord Mahavir is given a Mahabhishek where it is bathed with milk and flowers. Even a grand procession of Lord Mahavira's idol is carried out in the streets. Next festival is Ugadi, a festival to thank the deity. Ugadi is a regional New Year celebration for the people of Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana states. This auspicious harvest festival is observed by making rangolis on floor, decorations on doors called toran, buying and giving gifts and sharing special food. It is one of the famous festivals of India. Next festival is Chhath Puja, a festival dedicated to the sun god. On the 6th day of the Hindu month of Kartik, which falls in October or November on the Gregorian calendar, the Chhath Puja is a 4th day long festival dedicated to the worship of the sun god. The devotees pray to them, thanking for the life, wealth and health of themselves as well as their family. Many also bathe in the holy Ganga river. Many devotees also fast during the puja, following the legend at the fast of Rama and Sita to honor the sun god. Next festival is Gudi Padwa, grand harvest festival of Maharashtra. Gudi Padwa is the grand harvest festival mainly celebrated in the state of Maharashtra, marking the beginning of an auspicious new year. People make rangoli designs at the entrance of their homes and decorates it with flower. Folks meet friends and relatives and women cook sweets like Shrikhand, Puran Poli and Sundpak. Local people make gudi, that is bamboo doll, using mango and neem leaves and hang them at the entrance. Next festival is Losar. A famous Tibetan festival, Losar is one of the greatest Indian festival and celebration. Majorly celebrated in the neighboring region, that is Himachal Pradesh, Leh Ladakh, Arunachal Pradesh, Losar is a festival that is also celebrated in India by the Tibetans or the followers of the Buddhism residing in the nation. लोसार इज द तिब्बतीय न्यू ईयर दैट इज सेलिब्रेटेड इन अ फन एंड फ्रॉलिक वे. दिस ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व्स अ वे टू शो ग्रेटिट्यूड टू गॉड फॉर द हार्वेस्ट. नेक्स्ट फेस्टिवल इज हॉर्नबिल फेस्टिवल, द फेस्टिवल ऑफ फेस्टिवल्स, वन ऑफ द ग्रैंड फेस्टिवल फॉलोइंग इन द लिस्ट ऑफ इंडियन फेस्टिवल दैट इज सेलिब्रेटेड इन नागालैंड. इट इज नन अदर दैन द हॉर्नबिल. This week long festival is celebrated to show respect to their culture and folklore. Also famed as the festival of festivals, Hornbill is all about celebrating the ancient tribal conditions, traditions, lifestyles and heritages. Celebrated as the day of promote intercultural harmony between various tribes.